Welcome to Design Studio. This is our studio floor. This is where we develop all of our products. And as you see on the wall, it's absolutely full of artwork right now. At R2, we spent a lot of time thinking about how we design a vehicle that feels 100% Rivian, but new, fresh, energetic. It wasn't just one sketch, you know, there was hundreds and hundreds of hours and ideas that go into trying to find that perfect balance of what they need to be. The beauty of the studio is there's this amazing collaboration between engineering and design. So this creativity meets feasibility.
There's some cost constraints, and that's something that's very important without compromising the design in itself as well, because it's not just a beautiful design. It's just not a great sketch that we picked at the beginning. It's how we execute it.
We really need to see and touch and see the whole combination without like going too far. Like in production, you see this, oh my, I don't like this. So we're trying to make sure each stage, just checking step by step, like not no surprises at the end. It's not just one team's effort. We have to make sure we're doing this together as a whole company.
Doing a hot sketch is one thing, and then seeing a short car is another. But then actually seeing the car delivered to the customer and actually hearing their feedback and how happy they are with it, that's something that you can't put a price on.
Hi, everybody. I'm in our Franklin powertrain test lab. Here we have Maximus. Maximus is our next generation Rivian drive unit family. It will serve primarily in the R2 and R3 vehicles, and we're really proud of the progress that we've made since the Enduro. It's obviously smaller, it's way lighter, more cost-effective. We've also managed to reduce the number of fasteners by about 30%, so it makes it a lot easier to manufacture. We've mounted the inverter off to the side to give us a little bit more clearance in the vehicle for the lower R2. And we've gone to a continuous winding e-machine that gives us higher performance and also reduces by an order of magnitude the number of welds, also simplifying manufacturing. All in, we've got a drive unit here that is about 40% more power dense than Enduro, significantly cheaper, a lot easier to build, and really allow us to scale. This is the first drive unit which we've actually gone straight to hard tooling, meaning one moment you're looking at a drive unit on your computer screen, and the next moment it's sitting in a test lab ready to spin up and do a power thermal humidity test. This is what we call a Rivian modular dyno, which the team here have actually developed in-house. Not only do we use Enduro in our R1 vehicles, but we use them as dynos. And the property under test currently is Maximus. This drive unit is now undergoing about a month-long test of extreme low temperatures to extreme high temperatures to simulated rainfall events. Foundationally, we've really laid the groundwork from Origin to Enduro to Ascend and now Maximus in terms of understanding and optimizing the use case of the drive unit in a larger market across the globe. The organization is really structured in a way that allows us to go really, really fast in development. And that's sort of the secret sauce that I think Rivian have. And Maximus is the incarnation of all of that data coming together. It's behaving exactly what we predicted.
One of the things we're most excited about is we've actually spent the past few years building our technology to be vertically integrated. And we use a zonal architecture that allows us to develop very quickly and actually own the whole stack. Now we've been using that technology to build our R2 platform. And over the next year, we'll take that to more vehicles than anybody's been able to do with the zonal architecture to date.
So this is actually the next generation R2 steering wheel. They've talked a lot about the different haptics that are going to be going on with the steering wheel platform. So this is kind of the test bed that they're testing a lot of those features on right now. And on the table here, I have the focus on what this lab works on, which is the brain of the vehicle. And so you can see just the size difference in terms of the, you know, density of the hardware that we've been able to shrink down the platform. Everybody is kind of working towards making sure the hardware is reliable, robust, and ready to go, you know, on that first R2 vehicle rolls off production.
Behind me is the MSP lab car, which we're currently using for active testing and development. A lab car like this allows a developer to actually see all of the harnessing, all of the endpoint devices, everything on the LV side, that their SOC code might touch. So the stage between a lab car stage for MSP and the DVB, we have something called a mule, which is the bridging point between the lab car and the DVB build itself. So this is the 1A garage. This is where we work on and upfit all of our engineering test vehicles. This is the Mule 3.2. Come inside. Seats, screens, motors, zonals, all of it's representative of what we're about to see on our DVB build. All the perks of it being a full asset to see, can we charge, can we drive? While at the same time having the accessibility that lab car gives us. The next thing right after this is the DVB builds themselves, which would be a proper R2.